Hello everyone, welcome to this YouTube channel Unshackling Sudokus and Puzzles. Kishore here, and today we are going to solve a puzzle type called Doppel Block. This particular puzzle was created by Sally Alan, an author from Turkey, and it was contributed for the Logic Masters India Puzzle Rama and Round in 2017. The name of the round is Number Placement and Evergreens. I will add the link to the contest in the description. Do have a check. Now moving on to the rules. In each row and each column of the grid, we need to place two shaded cells, and in the remaining cells, we have to fill the digits from 1 to n minus 2, where n is the size of the grid. And the clues given outside indicate the total of the digits between the shaded cells in that row or column. So we have a 7 by 7 grid here, right? 7 rows and 7 columns. So we will have 2 shaded cells in each row and column and 5 digits which are filled. With that, let's start solving the puzzle. Let's focus on totals which are either higher or lower in value, as that would give a lot of information. So for the 10 clue, we need minimum 3 digits, right? 5 plus 4 plus at least one more digit we need for the 10. So for the 10 clue, we need at least a gap of 3 cells between the shaded cells. Now what happens if we shade row 6, column 4? We will not have a gap of 3 cells between the shaded cells in that row. So this cell cannot be shaded. We'll indicate that with the green. And similarly for the 10 clue in column 2, we cannot have this cell as shaded, because if this cell is shaded, row 4, column 2, we cannot attain the total of 10. The rest of the cells can be shaded, there is no problem. Now let's focus on row 1 a little bit. Can we have row 1, column 1 as shaded? No, because when we shade this cell, for the 2 clue we need to shade this cell as well, and now for the 1 clue is going to violate the rules, because we will have 2 shaded cells here and then we will have 1s in both of these cells, which is violating the rules, because as per rules you need to have 1 to n in each row and column, so that means digits do not repeat. So we can remove the shaded cells from there and also remove the pencil marks, so this will not be a shaded cell. And similarly we cannot shade this cell as well, because when we shade this cell, we have to shade this cell because this is unshaded, just now we did that. So this is again leading to a situation like just we saw previously. We need to shade these two cells for the one clue, and that is going to violate the rules. So which means row 1, column 3 cannot be shaded as well. And if we look closely along row 1, we will see that even row 1, column 7 is also not shaded. Because if we shade this cell, then we have to shade this cell for the 2 clue, so which will give us a 2 here. But what about this 2 clue? It has to come between the shaded cells, right? Here it is just outside the shaded cells. We cannot bound this by 2 more shaded cells, because we have to then shade outside the grid. So row 1, column 7 is also not shaded. We'll indicate that with the green. So for satisfying this 2 clue, we need to shade either row 1, column 2 and row 1, column 4, or we need to shade row 1, column 6 and row 1, column 4. In both of the cases we get a common shaded cell here, right? So we can shade that cell, that has to be shaded. And we will shade either row 1, column 2 or row 1, column 6. So, which means that one of these two cells will be a 2. And for this 2 clue, we can shade this cell. So, this will be a 2 now. And the rest of the cells can be unshaded along that column, because we have shaded 2 cells. And for the 6, we need at least 2 cells gap between the shaded cells, right? Because 6 cannot be satisfied using a single cell gap, because the digit range is only from 1 to 5. So 6 will need at least 2 cells to make it up. That means these 2 cells will be unshaded, and the shaded cell will either be in row 3, column 1 or row 3, column 7. So this cell will be unshaded because only these two, one of these two will be shaded. And now, because we unshaded this cell, can we have a shaded cell here? No, because then we would have to shade this cell, which is not possible, which means this cell will be shaded and this cell will be a 2. And rest of the cells we can unshade along that row. And for the 10th row we need minimum 3 digits, so this cell will be unshaded. And we can also not shade this cell, because then we will have 5 digits between the 10, which will get us to a total of 15. So this cell will also be unshaded. For the 7 total, if we look closely, one of these cells have to be shaded, row 7 column 1 or row 7 column 3. Because if you consider the opposite scenario where both the cells are not shaded, then this means these two cells will be shaded and we cannot satisfy the 7 total with a single cell. So one of these cells, row 7 column 1 or row 7 column 3, would have to be shaded. So that gives us that either this cell or this cell will be shaded. Because we have a 1 row outside, if this cell is shaded, this will be shaded, and if this cell is shaded, this will be shaded. So the common piece of information that we can extract is that one will either be here or here in row 6. Now focusing on this one, we can deduce that row 7 column 5 cannot be shaded, because if this cell is shaded, then we need to shade this cell. That will force a 1 here, which is violating the 1 which we got as pencil marks here, so this cell can be unshaded. In double block puzzles, it's about a question of asking which cell is shaded, which cell is not shaded. You will encounter a lot of these type of logics in this puzzle. So the moment we shaded this cell, can we shade row 7 column 1 now? Because what happens if we shade row 7 column 1? Row 7 column 3 cannot be shaded, and that gives us a continuous stretch of 4 cells which will take the total above 7. So which means that row 7 column 3 has to be shaded, and for satisfying this clue, this has to be shaded, and rest of the cells will be unshaded along that column, and we will get the 1 here, and this pencil mark can be removed now. So this is not going to be shaded cell. The 10th row will either have a shaded cell here or here, which is again not giving us much information. And the 7th row will either have a shaded cell here or here, which is quite possible again. Right, for the 1th row again, since row 3 column 5 and row 7 column 5 are shaded, we cannot have a shaded cell at row 5 column 5. Because if we have a shaded cell here, this will be shaded or this will be shaded, but both are unshaded, right? So this is not going to be shaded. So now we can deduce that row 4 column 5 is shaded, right? Because if this cell is not shaded, we have to shade these two cells in that column, and we are getting a total more than 1. So this will be shaded, and the second shaded cell will either be this or this. So which gives us that 1 should be either here or here. The 6th total can be made up of 2 cells, which is 1 5 and 2 4, which is again not giving us much information. But this 4th row, can we have a shaded cell here in row 2 column 1? Because if we shade that cell, this cell is not shaded because we have made a 2. We are getting a 3 cell sequence which will get the total above 4, right? So we can unshade that cell. So 4 cells we have shaded, there is only one possibility to satisfy the 4 in that row now, by using shaded cells here and putting a 4, that this is forced, which also means this is unshaded, because a cell can either be having a digit or a block in that. And now 1 is restricted in possibilities. So one will have its shaded cells here and here as one of the possibility, or it will have shaded cells here and here. So which means that one in that column should be in these two cells, the common piece of information. And similarly, we can see that for the 2, we can have the shaded cells in these two cells which will give the 2 here, or in these two cells which will give the 2 here. So the common piece of information is the 2 is in one of these two cells. Okay, we have marked two shaded cells in column 5, so we can use them to place the 1. And unshade rest of the cells. Okay, this is slightly difficult to see. I'll highlight and show using the red. So 2 has two possibilities, right? Either this scenario, which is quite possible, there is no contradiction, and this scenario. But what happens if we shade these two cells? Now we have satisfied the shaded cells in that rows 5 and 7, right? So that means the rest of the cells will be unshaded along that rows. So since we have two shaded cells in row 5, this cell, row 5 column 1 will be unshaded. So we will get the shaded cell for to satisfy the one in this cell and this cell, right? Because we cannot shade here, so this is the only possibility. Now immediately what happens is that if you look at row 6, row 6 column 2 cannot be shaded, and these 4 cells cannot be shaded. And since we have made 2 shaded cells here, even row 6 column 6 also cannot be shaded, so that gives us 5 cell sequence which cannot be shaded. So what that means is that we are taking the total to 15 with that, so which is violating this blue. So because of that, we can eliminate this scenario where row 5 column 6 and row 7 column 6 are shaded. So this means that this is the only possibility, and 2 will be in row 5 column 6, and we can unshade rest of the cells in that column. And since we have 2 shaded cells here, all these cells will be green, and that immediately gives us the possibility for 1 in that column, as there is only one possibility now because we unshaded this cell. We cannot have here and here, so there is only one possibility. The one will be in row 4 column 1, and we can unshade rest of the cells in that column. And we have marked 2 shaded cells here, so unshade the rest. And for the 10 blue, there is only one cell left for shading the second cell, which is going to be here. And we have 2 shaded cells here, so we will unshade the rest. And 2 shaded cells here, so we will unshade the rest. And for column 7, there is only one shaded cell left, and that we will mark it here. Now we have marked shaded cells in 2 shaded cells in each row and column. So now we have to come to the second part of the puzzle. The puzzle is not over yet. We have to satisfy the outside clues, right? So let's satisfy the 10 clue first, because it's higher in value. So 10 clue has just one cell outside the total. So that has to be a 5 to satisfy the 10 clue. These two 4 cells will be 1, 2, 3, 4 in some order and satisfy the 10. And now 7 total is made up of 3 cells that has only one possibility, which is 1, 2 and 4. But 2 is in column 6 and column 4, so 2 would be here, and 4 is in column 6, so this will be a 4 and this is a 1. And the only cell left in that row is 3, which will go here. And if you look at the 10 total, we have already 1 between the 2 shaded cells, so these 2 cells will add up to 9. The maximum possible value between any 2 cells in a 1 to 5 range is 4 plus 5. So we need to fill the 4 plus 5 here to get the 10 total. So this is a 4, so this will be a 4 now, and this is a 5. So to fill the complete the row, 2 and 3 has to come. The 3 is in row 7 column 1, so 3 would be here and 2 would be here. And to fill column 1, 4 and 5 are the remaining digits, but 4 is here, so this will be a 5 and this is a 4. And if you look at row 1, 2, 4 has been placed, 1, 3, 5 are left, but 1 is in column 5 and column 6, so 1 would be here. And the remaining digits will be 3, 5 in some order. And column 5 has 3 digits already. 3, 5 are the pending digits. And similarly, column 6 has 1, 2, 4, so 3, 5 are the remaining digits. Let's look at some outside clues to give us some information now. Okay, we have a 6 here, and we have marked the 2 shaded cells here. Now 6 can be made in 2 ways, 1 plus 5 or 2 plus 4. But 1 plus 5 is not going to be possible. So this is going to be 2 plus 4. But 2 is in column 3, so this will be a 2 and this will be a 4. And now this cell will be 3, 5, but 3 is in column 7. So this is a 3, this is a 5, which gives us a 5 here, a 3 here, and a 5 here. And column 3, if you look, we have 1, 2, 4. 5 is in row 2, so 5 has to be here and 3 has to be here. And 1 completes the row. And column 2 has 3, 4 as leftover possibility, so 3, 4 will be here. And column 4 will have 1 and 3 remaining digits, because 2, 4, 5 are in that column. And column 7 has 1, 3 and 5 already, so 2 and 4 are the remaining digits, but 2 is here. So that will give us a 2 here and a 4 here. And because of this 4, we get a 3 here and a 4 here, and a 3 here and 1 here, which finishes off this beautiful puzzle. So the main logics, if you see in this puzzle type, double block type, is that you have to constantly ask yourself the question whether this cell can be shaded. If this cell is shaded, can we satisfy a higher total? Whether the another cell can be shaded. So you have to constantly keep asking yourself the questions whether some cell can be shaded or not. And with the help of the totals, we have to fix the shaded cells. So hope you guys enjoyed watching this video. If you have been liking our videos, please remember to subscribe to the channel. We hope to make more of such videos in the future. Hope to see you all soon.